A hologram is a recording of light waves. It's so strange looking. I think that artists are drawn to that because it's so unique and sort of bizarre. My name is Matthew Schreiber. I'm an artist and I use holography in my practice. I've been making holograms since 1986, but always with the point of view as an artist, as what could you use with this as a material to make art with. Most people picture holography like what you might see in special effects in a science fiction movie. Real holograms are recordings of light that are recorded onto small glass plates. There are many different types of holograms, and we're gonna look at some of the process of making one type of hologram. So this entire thing is like a deconstructed camera, and I can rearrange all of these elements to have a different function to the camera. Right now, this camera that you see is set up to make a transmission master hologram. The transmission master hologram, you take an object. In this case, I'm using an incense burner, and you shoot laser light at it. So you have a single dot from a single laser. Then it first hits a beam splitter. That's what this is right here, and it cuts it into two beams. And that's where the magic of the process starts, is separating. Now you have two waves moving separately. This light here lights up the object, and it's bouncing around on this table through a bunch of mirrors and optics to get to here and light up this incense burner. So it's like lighting up an object in photography, but you're using lasers instead of normal lights. Then there's another bit of laser light, and that's called the reference beam. The reference beam is going to eventually to this plate holder, and the combination of the reference beam light and the object light comes together and creates an interference pattern that's recorded right here on this glass plate. An interference pattern, which is sort of the core of holography, it happens in sound, it happens with water, it happens with anything that's a wave. So you could imagine throwing two rocks into a pond of calm water. It's when these two waves of water come together and it makes a kind of a secondary wave. That wave pattern, the interference pattern, is recorded on a glass plate. One of the last things that I do, and I have all the materials prepared and loaded, I have to close everything up. All the vibrations, heat, the temperature from my body, everything has to dissipate before making the hologram. All of that has to stay completely settled for the entire exposure, so nothing can move, even on the micron level. The process itself is very difficult and very delicate. And even in the last stage, when I'm physically processing the holograms, which is a lot like photography, you still can't see anything. So there's this sort of tension when you're making something that you have no idea if it's gonna work or not. There is a magic to the material that I've been drawn to conceptually, but also just physically. It's still exciting for me because I never know what I'm gonna see.